My name is Virginia Frisina, and I have been making art in my studio since 1984 when I graduated from college at 43 years old. And it's something I've always wanted to do, and so I'm doing it. These are similar to my stitching, my drawing with needle and thread, but it's with paint. Which consists of drawing and painting with the paint, which creates this funky, fun, bright, rhythmic, overall composition. When I get stuck, I work with foam core, which I have an abundance of because I work at a frame shop. So I make these constructions, this one and that one, and all those up there on the wall are the mobiles. When I get stuck at my painting, I move to another direction, and then I can come back to my painting refreshed. It's just a 12-sided piece of abstract art. That's all I can say.
What does it represent?
Just another way of trying to figure it all out. They started originally with I'd make greeting cards for friends and send them through the mail. But maybe someday I'll go bigger on those, big. I have these illusions about big, but I really, the older I get, the harder it is, so. I think big should have been done when I was younger. These paintings were done 3 or 4 years ago, but these paintings became too comfortable for me. They were too easy, so I had to stop and move into something that was more challenging. My mother died at 93 years old, and the last few years of her life, the only thing she could do was crochet. She was the mother of 10 children and very active. But when she was reduced to just crocheting, and it kept her busy and happy until she did pass away. But when she did pass away, I did these drawings of her crocheting. This is the piece that got me going with stitching. Well, it could be a sanctuary. I do like to come here. It's a very robust studio. There's a lot going on. A lot has gone on in here in terms of making art. There's been a lot of discoveries and a lot of disappointments, but so I continue.
tack this up here so I can look at it. Because basically when I'm working on it, I can't really see it. So I tack it up. I don't know what this is going to end up as, but I just keep working on it. And then I just sit with a pillow. Work. And I look at Jackson Pollock for inspiration. Let's see. On these thread pieces, I basically use a running stitch, a chain stitch, or a buttonhole stitch, and that's about it. Nothing fancy. My husband got sick, and he wanted me to be home with him because he was afraid to be alone, so I don't know, I just thought, well, maybe I can do some sewing or something when I'm home. So instead of doing sewing or making things with material and thread, I started to do artwork with material and thread. And that's how I started to do this. It's something I could do and sit with my husband. And we could both be happy. And he thought they were pretty amazing. So he would always tell me they were absolutely gorgeous. So now it's just another form of art that I make. I make all kinds of art. I work with all kinds of materials and just do whatever strikes my fancy. And just have fun.